My fellow commissioners are, they're in the building and they'll be coming in, the ones that aren't here, but we'll start with our listening session here. We'll start with Chester Cullen. Chester?
Wait till the whole board's here to start.
Okay, well, I can tell you we're going to be missing at least one commissioner. He's not here today. And everybody else is now here. So please come forward, Chester.
Okay, very good. Sorry about that, but I don't want to waste everybody's time repeating myself continuously. Same thing. Your road sits on that. Remember when I stated the contractors had driven between no trespass signs to Bill Bryan's house? I have a document the contractor signed stating that they knew they were crossing with my permission, along with the other people who have permission to cross there. Susan Hutchinson provided testimony to the district court stating the temporary Hutchinson access was inhibited from my digging, I did on my property. This was to gain a temporary restraining order against my wife and I unjustly. Fact. John, Susan, Brian, and Tracy Hutchinson have already received a no trespass notice to stay off our property, hand delivered by the St. Louis County Sheriff's Office. And it's right here, I've got it. I won't waste time. Susan Hutchinson called the St. Louis County Sheriff's Office stating I was illegally blocking their access because I was placing no trespass signs along our property border. I guess driving between them is one thing, but when you got to drive alongside them, it's another. The deputy sheriff who responded explained to the Hutchinson family that they had every right to place signs, that we had every right to place the signs where they were, in fact. And they were, in fact, trespassing. The deputy had us handwrite a no trespass notification, and he delivered it to the Hutchinson family. Fact. From Sue Hutchinson's own photo, it's obvious my digging was off the trail and completely on my property. And I have pictures. This is what I've been telling you. Every expense put on us. Fact, their own tracks demonstrate they knew, even though my signs were down, they took them down repeatedly, I told you. Their own tracks demonstrate they knowingly continue to trespass on our property, and I had not impeded their temporary access in any way. These examples alone demonstrate Susan Hutchinson's willing to give false and misleading testimony without any regard to the place of this place of reverence. It demonstrated the need to ensure fairness during the Cartway process. The burden of proof and cost should not be placed on the property owner whose property may be unfairly taken. At the Cartway hearing, I stated I looked for 2 years for our property, and that something needed to change. View the Cartway hearing, and then tell me you're good with what has gone on here.
Chester, thank you very much. You do understand that this has been through the court system, and this board has only got so much power. Thank you very much. With that, we have Lee Branville. Lee, please come forward.
Good morning, Lee Branville. Chairman Nelson and rest of the commissioners, I thank you for this time. Approximately a year ago, I came before the board as I had a, without going into a lot of the detail, perhaps you remember that I sat on a nonprofit board of the Fairhood Center in Virginia, and we had some difficulties with the management of the firm, and at that time the IRS stepped in, and several of the board members were attached liens on their property and had their, in my case, my wages and everything reduced to about $300 a week, and I became very delinquent on taxes and a contract I had with St. Louis County. At that time, you granted me till December of this year to work through the problem with the IRS and make payment to you. The IRS eventually did release all liens. My income was reestablished, and I received a quite large or substantial sum back from the IRS of money that they had garnished from me, which was actually my money. Unfortunately, they didn't give me, there was a 1 year that they decided that they were not going to grant me back. There, apparently there's a time that they will go back. So I didn't receive 100% of what I was due, but I did receive upwards of about $90,000. And in December, I made payment on my contract C221800059 of a payment of $52,369 and some change, and another portion towards some delinquent taxes of $32,203 for a total of $84,500 approximately, leaving me a balance due on my delinquent taxes of $39,262. I did receive I had the contract. I did actually receive a statement now, dated February 2nd, on that contract for an annual payment. So I'm just wondering if I'm able to proceed now with this contract again and continue to pay off the balance due on my taxes, which as of now will not be a problem because I've reestablished my complete income and foresee no problem on making contract payments and hopefully some additional tax payments during the year, as well as my normal taxes, in May and October. So I'm asking if this contract can be reinstated so that it can continue to pay off my taxes.
Lee, I know this whole board is familiar with your issue because we worked through some of those parts of it, but on the technical pieces of it, I'm going to need you to talk to Deputy Administrator Fritzinger and the county auditor, because they're the ones that will manage. The auditor's office obviously is going to be the one that manages it. So let's give that a try. Okay. And again, like I said, I know this whole board is familiar with the issue and how you were wronged. Okay. And I mean, that's really what it gets to. And we wanted, at that time, we instructed them to help you in any way we could, okay, to get this rectified at some point. So we'll stop here now because I need to get you with the right people to fix this, okay? But I again, my recollection is in Clinton, this board gave a very clear directive. Anybody not remember that? That was my recollection. So we'll go from there if that works for you. Okay.
Well, sure. So could I just get back to you on this?
No, we're gonna try and get you with Brian, can you walk this through and get Lee over to our auditor's office and hopefully get this figured out? And we'll be around, okay?
All right, thank you, sir.
All right, and you can call me anytime, you know that. Okay.
All right. So thank you very much for your time.
All right, thank you. Lee is one of my constituents to this board, okay, but I know we don't normally address back, but it just makes sense here to a couple of things that we're hearing about. Anybody else who cares to address the board on items not on the agenda here today during our listening session? Is there anyone else who cares to address the board at this point? With that, we'll Commissioner, stick around. Somebody might walk in, but obviously the board meeting will start at 10 o'clock. Okay. So we'll wait for that.